Hi, I'm Sara McAllister. I'm a research mechanical engineer at the Rocky Mountain Research Station, Missoula Fire Sciences Lab. So I got into mechanical engineering because I knew I liked math and science, and I had a curiosity about how things worked, but I wasn't sure exactly what I wanted to do. Mechanical engineering is an incredibly broad field. It covers everything from cars to spacecraft to heating and air conditioning systems, roller coasters, basically almost anything that defines modern life. So it leaves you a wide range of options to go into. And when I was an undergrad, I became really interested in how my old Volkswagen Beetle worked. So I went into grad school. I was really interested in looking in studying combustion and heat transfer and fire. And so I actually, as my Ph.D. dissertation, I looked at the material flammability in spacecraft. So I went from looking at how materials like plastics burn in space to how wildfires burn on Earth. And believe it or not, they're incredibly similar. I don't see a lot of women pursue this kind of career, and it's kind of sad. I was one of the few women who went through mechanical engineering in both undergrad and graduate school. You know, it's such a wide field, and it has such like broad implications, and you can really like help society in a lot of different ways by going into mechanical engineering. And I think more women need to definitely get into it and appreciate that fact, and just get through those math and science classes. Some of my favorite things about what I do, other than the fact that I light things on fire all day, is just how incredibly challenging and broad the problem is. To understand wildland fire involves understanding all sorts of complicated interactions between not only engineering fields like fluid mechanics and heat transfer and the chemistry, but also things like plant biology and plant physiology, because ultimately it's the live fuels in the trees that are burning, and they respond to different stresses and fire in lots of different ways, and that actually influences a lot of how fires behave.